Hey guys, Dave and Wemi here, and we are marriage tuning up some more. We have the family life getaway package, and you know what? We need to talk.
Let's talk,
baby. I hope that actually focused and you guys could read that, because otherwise I'm just holding up a big orange envelope or big orange piece of paper and you guys are wondering what's going on. So the we need to talk session was it was actually pretty good. It was understanding better how to communicate with your spouse and what's meaningful to him or her. So first one out of the gate, you guys know this. It's basically five love languages. Easy.
We did that with you guys.
Yeah. So it was talking about, do you know your love language? And we're like,
we do.
So they have, words of affirmation, quality time, receiving gifts, acts of service, and physical touch. And so right now I'm holding Wemi's book, so it looks weird because it's like, do you know your love language? And it says my mate's is words of affirmation, but I was like, that's totally mine. And Wemi's is obviously quality time, receiving gifts, and acts of service. So she's all over the map. But so it's a great start to this session was with that, and hopefully you guys, if you haven't already, read Five Love Languages and know it yourself.
It's a great book for friendships, relationships, just great.
Very easy read, and we only get a small commission.
We don't get anything. Zero.
And I wish we'd get a commission on some of these things. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, so
communication styles. We talked about the fact that our individual differences lead us to develop communication patterns as a couple.
Right.
So we talked about things like an internal processor versus an external processor. Someone who goes on facts versus feelings. Minimizing issues or just conversations versus magnifying. Personalizing things versus externalizing things. Being a digital communicator or face-to-face communicator.
And this was an interesting one too, because I think this was when they made people stand up, right? I think it was just before this, because this basically showed a whole lot, the differences between, the spouses kind of thing. Like, a lot of times you'll fall on opposite ends of the spectrum. If you want to hold up your book,
both did it for each other.
Yeah, you do where you think you are and where you think your spouse is, and you hold
so
it up.
So this is Dave's book of what he thinks.
And so you can see the X's and O's are kind of just
so
on
who's
separate.
An X?
I don't know, but it doesn't matter. Yeah. But they're on separate sides of... Okay, you're good.
Okay.
Separate sides of each of the things. So it's just showing, the differences that spouses have, including us. Then we went on to communication patterns. So this is just trying to identify some places where, how you think, what's your pattern. So some of the statements, and you're supposed to check which ones apply to you kind of thing, are... As soon as my partner expresses concern, I begin to problem solve. Yeah, totally. I am uncomfortable with emotion, so when my spouse starts talking about feelings, I withdraw. I like concise communication, so when my spouse takes too long to get to the point, I start finishing his or her sentences or I check out. So it's just things like that, and totally. And we go back and forth on the check marks. It's really funny. Like, between the two of us, we check every one of the sentences, but I think we only shared one.
Yeah.
It's kind of funny, but it's identifying what your communication patterns are.
Yeah. So they had us compare these communication styles, share our observations, and just get to a better way of understanding. Because now you can better see what you actually do to communicate and how that may or may not affect your partner.
Yeah, and on that note, it was funny. The very first statement about immediately you try to problem solve, that came from, I think it was Five Love Languages. Love and Respect.
Yeah.
And how sometimes a man with his blue goggles on, or blue ears on, he'll hear a problem and just want to fix it. But sometimes...
I just want to rent.
Yeah, exactly. And so it was kind of funny. It was good to hear. It was reinforced. Like, we already knew it, but it was reinforced, so it was positive.
Yep. Then they talk about just listen. So here we got four key points. Show genuine interest. Focus your attention. Minimize distractions like your phone. And make time to actually have the conversations.
Why are you laughing? Go on.
And then two, listen in order to understand. This one for me is one that I tuned into a couple of years ago, and I try to use it in my daily life, but quite often emotions get in the way and, you know, you get all caught up in your feelings.
Sure.
But really just learning to have listen with the intent to understand and not the intent to reply. Because quite often in life we all listen to rebut, to immediately rebuttal and to just snap back or say something in response rather than just taking time to, you know what, shut off the brain, stop thinking of what to say, and just listen to what the person is saying. Very important point.
Is it bad that the whole time you were talking, I was like, is it rebut or rebuke?
Rebuke. See? Listen to understand.
Yeah, listen to rebuke.
Yeah.
I had it.
Uh-huh. So in that, they talk about resist assumptions, interruptions, and false conclusions. Listen to emotions as well as words, because sometimes your partner might not have the words to express their emotions, and sometimes their emotion might not reflect their words. So listen to both and focus on the intended meaning rather than analyzing every word.
Right.
So same point I just said, go.
I was going to say, there's, you know, good examples of this is like, you know, all, I think I have, you know, sorry, I'm just taking a break here. You say so, I say, you know, so much. Anyway, you know, no, I'm just kidding. When you give examples kind of thing and you're just trying to express a point,
mm-hmm.
and it's that example that's taken so literally and it's like, no, that's not what I mean. Like, I'm, you know, you're trying.
It's just an example.
Yeah, yeah. You're trying to get something out. But so you got to be careful. You got to help the other person because it's important in communication.
Right now, Dave's trying not to throw shade.
What do you mean?
Trying to throw shade at me because I do that.
You don't... I get stuck in the
point. Examples literal.
Oh, okay. We both do then, because that's okay. Don't worry.
All right, point number three. Yeah. Ask good questions in order to understand. So clarifying facts and information while the person's speaking, saying, you know, what do you mean by that? Tell me more about that. Another one is probing questions. So how did you feel when blah, blah, blah happened? Why is the situation so important to you or so negative to you? Asking those questions, probing and clarifying to bring out the person's feelings and what they really want out of you and out of the situation.
Yep.
And last but not least, communicate understanding, affection, and solidarity. We are one. I've got your back, you've got mine. Communicate that throughout these important conversations. This isn't Black Power.
Oh,
I know
sorry.
We're Black right now, but you know, it's just, yeah. In that same sentence is like, you know, if I were you, I would feel this.
Yeah.
Shows that you're putting yourself in their shoes and solidarity is being communicated.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what do you need from me? We're in this together. Saying those sentences during those moments goes a long way.
So it's just listen, then we get, say what?
Say what?
So this is basically, on the other end, you know, you can only listen if someone's talking. And this is trying to encourage when you're speaking to speak better, I guess. So it's one, know what you want to say. You know, what are you feeling? What's the issue? What are you trying to get? What do you need from your spouse right now? You know, make sure there's a point to what you're saying in your words.
Yep. And key thing here, which I personally have an issue with in understanding myself, is it's not the same thing as what am I thinking. What you're thinking is not always the same as what you're feeling. So learn to separate those two and communicating them accordingly is important.
Right. excuse me. And the second point is think before you say it. Yeah, this guy could practice that. So there's also a nice little, what do you call those?
Acronym.
Yeah, here you go for think. So is it true? T. Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it necessary? And is it kind? And basically, you know, you kind of want those to be true and, it, you know, with your spouse, like that, that communication, like I think a big part, is it true? Yeah. Like why are you lying? Don't lie. We saw this stat before, you know, honesty, that's number one need. The third point is say it well. So choose your timing. I can't stress that enough. Man, you know, timing is actually very important. There might be something that's very critical that you need to say to your spouse, but just choose the right time. If she's a little hangry, you know, just...
An example she gave of this is when I was trying to have an important conversation with her husband, one of the ladies that had the talk with us. She said she'd make sure that, you know, he's home from work. She doesn't just, as soon as he walks in the door, say, babe, I hate you for doing this. No. Let him come in, have his meal, eat, relax, unwind, then load him up with information.
Yeah. So it's interesting, yeah. Choose your words. This kind of goes on to the next point of being positive versus negative. So there's an interesting stat here in that marriages that flourish, the positive to negative ratio of comments, 5-1 positive. So for every one negative thing you say, you have to say 5 positive things and your marriage should flourish. Now, marriages that end in divorce, 1-1. And like, that's scary. If you think about it, like, you know, it doesn't sound that low, I guess. In terms of numbers, you're just like, oh, well, for everything nice you say, or everything bad you say, say something nice. And it's like, that should be okay. No. And even
just think about living in that situation. That can get overwhelming really, really easily. Because you'll always feel like everything good you do is canceled out.
Yeah. And even if everything negative you say 2 good things? No.
Yeah.
Not good enough. You really gotta... strive to be better than that. The guys from that weekend took a challenge. This came a little bit later, but we took a challenge. We're trying to do 7-1. We're going 7
They've
positive
been working on that.
Interactions. Really well. It's not always words. It's not always words. 7 positive interactions
it's
for everyone.
It's holding hands, giving him a kiss, saying I love you. Love you.
Oh, man.
His mustache hurts, guys. I'm not gonna lie.
Your lipstick hurts.
No, it doesn't.
Man, that's a negative interaction. Now I owe her 6 more. But anyway, so that was 3. The fourth and final part of say what is ask for feedback from your partner to make sure you're being understood. So don't just assume. It's very, you know, especially when you're in your own mind, right? You can get out to lunch and your spouse might just kind of nod along, but make sure they're understanding and so that, you know, there's not later confusion and conflict.
Something funny here is, I know if there are times when someone's talking to you and you tune out, and it's embarrassing to come back like, I wasn't listening to you, like I completely tuned out. But I challenge everyone out there that if you do that, own up to it and don't be afraid to say, you know what, I'm very sorry, I tuned out for a second there, I don't know why, but I did. You weren't boring me, but I apologize. Could you please explain that again?
Yeah.
Because you probably could save yourself a lot more drama down the road when they bring it up again. You're just like, what? Like, it was when we were watching Blackish, and this happened on the show where her daughter was talking to her, she kept tuning out. The girl was like, so mom, what should I do? Write a love letter? I don't know, like, what were you talking about? So, just save yourself that.
Absolutely.
And so, in this, they recommended, funny enough, the books they recommended, one of them was 5 Love Languages, which you guys have already heard about from us. Hopefully you've read it, and if not, check it out. And I'm going to leave you guys with one last quote they gave us.
Go for it.
Communication skills are honed in everyday conversations, so that when they are put to the test in conflict, healthy patterns are already established.
Man.
That is all.
So violent with that book. Awesome. So that was We Need to Talk, Relational Oneness of the, what was it again?
Marriage Life?
Family Life. I was thinking Marriage Life. Family Life Getaway. Weekend Getaway. So Marriage Tune Up with Dave and Wemi, Moments of Love. We'll see you for the next one. Thank you.